Praise Jesus. Praise the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And for the Rock Intercessor Ministries, I'm here today to preach to you about Jesus Christ. Hope that some of you will give your heart to Jesus Christ today. Today's message is, your body is the temple of God. Your body is the temple of God. And now, your body is what we all have in common. And so I have to say something today that concerns you, because every one of us has body. Except the body without spirit, the Bible says dead. And the Bible teaches us in Genesis chapter 2 verse 7, then the Lord God formed the man of dust and from the ground, and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and the man became a living creature. So now that's the origin of man. He has two sources. Man is partly from beneath the dust, the earth, the clay. And also, man is partly from above, the Spirit of God. Now, if you think of it, all of us have this experience in our lives. And there's a conflict. There's something that is in us that wants to drag us downwards. And also, there's something also in us want to drag us upwards. And I believe today, as the Bible has explained to us ourselves, Jesus Christ himself explained this in the book of John chapter 1 verse 3. All things were made through him, and without him was nothing anything made that was made. Jesus Christ formed us. Jesus Christ formed man from the dust, from the ground of clay, and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life. And then man became a living creature. It is a miracle that we are here today. And this amazes me today. How can anyone who believe that you are here by accident? My friends, you are not here by accident or by incident. That also amazes me. When I hear by the Big Bang theory, I just know who banged it. His name is Jesus. Also amazes me when I hear people talking that we are from the animal. Last time I checked, I never seen monkey giving birth to a human being. And therefore, if you say you are offers of ape, you are making monkey out of yourself. But you see, we are the product of clay and the Spirit of God. David says in Psalm 139 verse 13, for you formed me in our parts. You connect me together in my mother's womb. And I praise you. Now watch it. For I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works, and my soul know it well. My friend was hidden from you when I was being made in secret, integrating woven in the depths of the earth. Your eyes saw my unformed substance. In your book, it's been written that every one of them and the days you are formed for me, and yet I was none of them. So you should not downgrade your body, my dear friend. You should never downgrade your body. Why? The Bible says you are fearfully and wonderfully made in the image of Christ. So our body is a miracle. And that's the purpose why God created us. It is said in 1 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 19. Or don't you know, just in case if you forget or if you don't know, it says, or don't you know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit within whom you have from God. You are not on your own, for you have been bought with a price. Now watch it. So glorify God in your body. Now the question here is this. Why did God create a body for a man? The answer is amazing, my dear friend. He wanted the body of a redeemer, of a redeemed believer, to be a temple for where he dwells in, and through his power, the Holy Spirit of God. So if you see it in this perspective, it gives you a totally different attitude towards your own body. For your body was designed to be a temple place for God to dwell in. The Bible says, for God does not dwell in a temple that was being made by hand. You can have a building, synagogue, church or cathedral, whatever it may be. God does not dwell in building. But God dwell in us. Apostle Paul said, in him we live and have our being. So God have designed you. You are his own temple. Your body does not belong to you. The Bible says you have been purchased and paid for by the blood of Jesus Christ. Almighty God, the creator of heavens and earth, wants to occupy in our physical body and to make it his own temple. And when Jesus Christ was speaking about the Holy Spirit in the John chapter 7 verse 38, now listen to it. Whosoever believes in me, as the scripture has said, out of his heart will flow rivers of living water. And for he spoke of the Spirit, that's the area within your physical body God wants to occupy, where his Holy Spirit wants to dwell. Jesus Christ said, in human being body, that's the area where God wants his Holy Spirit to dwell in you. So if you analyze it and realize it, that your own body, your actions, your feelings, there's a place in your body where we always receive the most impact. The place where you feel pain, the place you feel happy, and the place you feel sad, or when you are weak, or when you are strong. God wants to do it in that inner part of your body called heart. God has chosen a place where he wants to dwell, and he wants his spirit to be in the life of a believer. That inner part of your personality. The Bible said then, that follows from your mouth, and that particular area, what the Bible calls the heart. That is not unusual place by the physical heart that pumps the blood, but the inner place that Jesus Christ said, when the heart is overflowing, it's overflowing in the mouth through speech. So that is the purpose which God created your body, as a dwelling place for the Holy Spirit of God. And so the result of a man's rebellion against God, his own personality was affected. The scripture described it, that man in total condition is apart from God, is what corrupt. If you don't have Jesus Christ living in you, my dear friend, your body is totally corrupt. So every human being today has personality, but God has came and wants to dwell in your heart. But if there's any corruption that is in your hand, let me say to you today, my dear friend, you are spiritually corrupt, you are morally corrupt, you are physically corrupt. And the end of physical corruption is death. Death is simply the answer. That is the finished process of corruption. Apostle Paul says, by one man sin entered into the world. By one man, that's Adam, and then death by sin, and death passed on to all men. The Bible says, for all have sinned and fall short of glory of God. So you see, true sin brings the poison of corruption that enters into our body. The Bible says this in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 56. The sting of death is sin. Just like a bee produces, is poisonous into the bodies with a sting. The same way Satan produces poison of corruption. And death comes through the sting of sin. So you see, we all have become corrupt creatures. In Philippians chapter 3, verse 21, what Apostle Paul called our present body, a lowly body. It is a body of humiliation. We are being humiliated because we rebel against our Creator. So you see, no matter how elegant you may look, or you may be, you might be strong or healthy, you might be wealthy or famous, but you still have a body of humiliation. So no matter how strong you may feel right now, it takes one sickness, my dear friend, to put you to death. Just even imagine what coronavirus have done. You know how many people have passed away through coronavirus? We are rebelling against the Almighty God. So we are transgressions against Almighty God. As a result of this, Apostle Paul says in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 13 and following, concerning your body, he says, your body is not meant for sexual immorality, but for the Lord, and the Lord for the body. And then he said, don't you know that your bodies are members of Christ? So should you, my dear friend, take the members of Christ to unite you with the apostle? He says, never. 16, or he said, don't you know that he who joined them to a prostitute becomes one body with her? For it is written, the two shall become one flesh. But he who joined the Lord becomes one spirit within him. And that's what he says in verse 18, flee from sexual immorality. Every sin that a person commits is outside his own body. But the sexual immorality person sins against his own body. And here's the warning, by the way. He said, oh, don't you know, the unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of God. That's the main reason he says, don't you be deceived. Neither sexual immorality, nor adulterers, non-adulterers, non-men who practice homosexuality, non-thief, non-greedy, non-drunkards, non-revivers, non-swindlers, we inherit the kingdom of God. However, here's the good news. Such you are some of you. Now listen to it. But you have been washed. You are satisfied. You are justified in the name of the Lord. Jesus Christ died to redeem us, my dear friend, from all sin. And not only that, he redeemed us, the whole human being body. Peter speaking about this, about Lord Jesus Christ in 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 24. He says, in him, he bore our sin in his own body on the tree, that you might die to sin and live righteousness. Now watch it, by his wound, you have been healed. So Jesus Christ took our sin on his own body. He became a sin offering. He took the cross upon himself on his own body on the cross, that he might revive us from sin. And the scripture says he took also our infirmities, our sickness on his own body. The Bible says by his wound that you might be healed. And so as far as God concerned, we already healed. Amen. Apostle Paul says this again in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 23. Now may God of peace himself satisfy you completely, holy, and may your whole spirit and soul and body be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. That's why he's going to tell us in Corinthians chapter 6 verse 19. Or don't you know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit within you? God bless you. Your body is temple of the Holy Spirit within you, of whom you have from God. You are not on your own. So what is your body? Your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. For you have been bought with a price. At what price? The blood of Jesus Christ. And then he says, glorify God in your body. And that's so important for us to understand that Jesus Christ has redeemed us, the whole spirit, soul, and body. And that's one of the reasons your body has become the temple of God. So you see, the Lord will not dwell in a temple that is not redeemed. If your temple is a body full of sin, the Spirit of God will not dwell in it. If your temple has become the synagogue of the devil, of the Satan, God will not dwell in it. But if your body has been redeemed through the Holy Spirit and through the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, what is the response? Call to mind then what Apostle Paul says in chapter 12 verse 1. I appeal to you, brothers, therefore, by the mercies of God, present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is, by the way, is a special worship. And so what God has asked for us to do here is this, is to respond to our Lord Jesus Christ down upon that cross. You want to see, my friend, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice. Because you see in the Old Testament, the animal were present to God as a sacrifice. But Apostle Paul said, you place your body, don't kill it, but you place your body, leave it there on that altar as a living sacrifice. So everything that has been placed on the altars of God belongs to God. That's the message. Your body is the temple of God. So everything you have today, my dear friend, place it on the altar of God. Your body as a living sacrifice, because your body belongs to Jesus Christ. And your body is the temple of God, as a living sacrifice unto God. And then Apostle Paul going to say, and give us two reasons why, that you should live for God. The first reason he says, it is holy. The second reason he said, it's acceptable to God. So holy simply means being set apart. Your life is a special purpose. God bless you, son. When we give our life to our Lord Jesus Christ, when we surrender to him, when we lay everything to the feet of our Lord Jesus Christ, we present our body as a living sacrifice. And that is a holy thing to do. And then he says it's acceptable to God. So acceptable sacrifice, how do you do it? He said, first of all, you offer yourself as a living sacrifice. Secondly, it is holy. Thirdly, it's an acceptable sacrifice. Now listen, friends, your body is a temple of God. Your body, my body, our body is a temple of Almighty God. So when we offer ourselves to God, it is holy and acceptable thing in the eyes of God. Because you see, my dear friend, if we do this, we offer it to our Lord Jesus Christ. That means it's through his blood, through the sacrifice on the cross, through him our body sanctified. That's very important. Our body has been washed away from any iniquities, from every sin. Because you see, that is only way that offering is acceptable. And it's been set apart by the cleansing work of Jesus Christ on that cross. Your temple will be unacceptable to God if it's not been washed through the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. So my dear friend, your body is the church, your body is the temple, and your body is the temple of God. We have been purified, and that's the great news, and that's the good news I'm preaching to you today. When we offer ourselves to God, we are now acceptable to God through the sacrifice of Jesus Christ upon that cross of Calvary. That's what Apostle Paul is telling us today, that you invite Jesus Christ into your life, my dear friend, by saying, give yourself to Jesus Christ. Your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit within you, where God wants to dwell. The Bible says you have been bought and paid for. Your body does not belong to you. I used to hear people tell me, Brother Kingsley, my body is my body. I want to do what I want to do with it. No. Your body belongs to Jesus Christ. Amen. You can't use your body to sleep with an harlot. You can't use your body to sleep around. You can't change your sex. Everything that you have, your body is the temple of God. Today, it is okay now today to call yourself gay in UK. It is okay now to call yourself homosexuality. It is okay now to call yourself lesbian, LGBT. But the Bible says no. Your body has been bought and paid for by the blood of Jesus Christ. So your body does not belong to you. Your body belongs to Almighty God. And the Bible says, glorify God in your body. That's why Apostle Paul is saying this. Why? Because Jesus Christ has suffered upon the cross of Calvary. He has the right. He has earned the right to call you, your body, his body. Your body belongs to Jesus Christ. It is at the right. And by the way, he says, which is your special worship, in him, in Jesus Christ, we live, we have our being, and we move. Your body is the temple of God. Amen. Blessed in the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus Christ is Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Jesus Christ is Lord.